We haven't. I'm quite surprised to see this particular type of creepy crawly let me start that again. I went to say Brian for a moment, and of course, Brian is no longer with us. He's taken an absence of leave, but we've got Byron. Sorry about that, Byron. But yes, we have a caterpillar of some sort, and it is beautiful. I remember seeing them at the beginning of the year. We're seeing loads and loads of them. If you remember the sighting I had once with Ngahumas, where I had a caterpillar, well, crawl on my body, and then I tried to release it quite safely into the sighting, and it ended up getting caught. The branch got caught on the car, and then I flung it, and I thought I flung it to its death, but I didn't fling it to its death. I actually just flung it straight onto my neck, which I found just before the show ended. And this is exactly the same kind. One you would not want to have on your body, because as you can see, it is covered in long bristly hairs, and unfortunately that is no good for us. Those are there as a defense mechanism. They will break off and they will cause you to itch and scratch like you have never felt pain and itchiness in your life, a combination of the two really. So don't touch any hairy caterpillars, they are no good. But how beautiful is this? Now it's sitting very still. I wonder if it's not because it is a bit chilly still and it hasn't just got enough energy to start moving yet. But it's exceptionally vulnerable sitting out in the open like this, because there's still a few cuckoos around. We're still seeing the Jacobin and the great spotted cuckoo, and they are experts at catching caterpillars. So this little fella better get a move on, and it's quite large too. Shall we use my hand as a scale again? Would love to show you. This is the biggest one of this particular species of caterpillar that I have seen. It is very, very long. Now what you could do is you could probably allow it to walk on your hand and you'd be okay. The problem, however, comes in when the top side, so these top hairs, actually touch you. Those black ones, oh, they would make you itch very badly. Now, I don't know, this could even be a moth, because I can't remember if we got a clear identification of this particular caterpillar, but I have since received, not received, I've purchased quite a few different types of butterfly books from Australia. I got some new ones, so maybe they will have a picture in them of a larvae that looks similar to this, and we'll be able to figure out exactly which one it is. But isn't it stunning though? Blend in very well to a marula tree. Now, Eliana, you're wondering, and you're only 3 years old, I must mention that, if it would hurt to pet this caterpillar, it would indeed. So, Eliana, you wouldn't want to pet this one, so that's why I haven't actually touched it, because I love caterpillars. I put them on my face sometimes when I'm feeling silly, but this one, you want to leave on the ground. And I wonder if it hasn't come from the marula tree. If you just have a very quick look at its coloration, and then come and look at it, look, come and look at this massive marula tree that's right here. You see that? Almost uncanny how identical the sort of colors match with the bits of the black. The darker colors even on the hairs on the caterpillar will match the darkened spots of bark on this marula tree. So that could be a clue, of course, to what that caterpillar is, and maybe a marula tree is the larval's host species. That's what it will be feeding on. But it's not just the caterpillar that I've got that's quite beautiful. I've actually just